Even through the challenges of 2020, as we reflect back on this year, we can say God has been good. He's been faithful. And even through the things we haven't understood and through the disappointments, we have found so many things to thank Him for. And all of us would agree that we are in the blur of it all. It's a hustle and bustle, and sometimes it's a frenzy. But in the middle of all of that, there are certain dates on our calendars that we hear a knock at the door. And when we hear that knock, everything within us stands up because we realize now is the time that we've looked forward to, of this one that we haven't seen in a while. Or sometimes it may be somebody you rub shoulders with every day, but you realize this get together is here that you have planned for so long. And once we hear that knock, it is such a joy to run to the door, open the door, and there they stand. Sometimes it's a whole family that we have looked so forward to this time of sweet fellowship. In Revelation 3:20, we hear the voice of the Lord where He says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and I will sup with him and he with me." Now, I realize that this particular scripture is generally referring to the Lord knocking on someone's heart and for them to open the door to be saved. But I feel like today that we can use this in the context of being surrounded by the holidays and realizing that there are many knocks that we hear on the door, and we open the door because we're excited to spend time with this person. And sometimes it's somebody that, as we've said, you've rubbed shoulders with day in and day out, but it's a special time of fellowship that you've looked forward to. As far as myself, there are many times that I open my Bible as I have heard that knock, and I know the Lord is ready to spend time with me and fellowship with Him. But sadly, my mind is somewhere else. I'll read sometimes 10, 12 verses, a whole chapter, and to my dismay, I realize once I've closed my Bible, I did not comprehend not one word that I read. Or I've prayed. I've said all the right words, and I've spoken out of my heart as I have communed with the Lord and spent that time in fellowship with Him. But my mind has been somewhere else. And there are times I feel like the Lord would feel somewhat disappointed and even offended at me, as I would feel as I sit down with that person that I've looked so forward to spending time with, and I can tell their mind is not there. They've got sometimes it's the pressures of life, or just they don't seem as excited as what I am of seeing them and spending that time with them. And when it comes to reading the scripture, I have realized lately that I have a trait of being a speed reader, but it's to my detriment. I can read fast, but once I have read, I realize, as I mentioned a while ago, I didn't comprehend what I read. My mind wasn't truly there as I spent time with the Lord in prayer. So with reading scripture, one thing I've been doing over the last several months and even a couple years, once I've closed my Bible, I will ask myself, what did I just read? I'll ask myself, what was the last sermon that I just heard in church? And granted, because we're living busy lives, there's times it takes a minute to recall that. But I feel like it's something that the Lord has been working on me for the past several months and even couple years, to realize if I'm not applying my concentration to a message or to my prayer time or to my time spent in the Word, it is compared to sitting down at a meal with somebody and your mind is totally somewhere else. They sense it, and when I look back, I realize that I have not properly concentrated on that spiritual nourishment, and because of that, I'm not going to be able to properly digest it as I should. And I realize that one of the ways that we take in spiritual nourishment as we should is to meditate on what we've read, meditate on what we've heard. And David said in Psalms 119 and 97, "Oh, how I love thy law. It is my meditation all the day." And we realize once we've got up from a meal during the holidays, We know that that meal was extra special to us when we remember what Grandma made, or we remember the pie that Aunt So-and-so brought. Even if you don't know who brought it, you remember some specifics about that meal, and you realize you concentrated on what you ate, and most of all, you concentrated on the fellowship that you had with that person that you love so much. Through the coming weeks leading up to Christmas, we know that we're going to be in a blur more than ever some days. And we're waiting on particular knocks to come at the door because there are certain dates on the calendar that we're preparing for. But Lord, help us not to forget that with all the knocks that we hear at the door and all the responsibilities and the obligations and the Christmas get-togethers that we're involved in, there's somebody else waiting at the door. And He is wanting to spend time with you. He's wanting to spend time with me. And Lord, help us to not forget that knock or to ignore that knock, because it's every day. It's not just once a year. It's not just a few times at the end of the year during a special holiday season. But this knock is there every day, and He wants to spend time with us. And as we meditate on His Word, as we leave our times of a fellowship with Him, whether it be reading the Word, or whether we are walking out the church doors, or whether we've been on our knees at a personal devotion time, let's meditate on what we've read, on what we have talked with the Lord about. And David said in Psalm 104 and 34, "My meditation of Him shall be sweet. I will be glad in